Hi, my name is Kent. I'm the creative specialist on the Google Web Designer team, and I'd like to show how to create animated GIFs in Google Web Designer. There's a few different ways to make them, and the simplest when starting a new file is to select Animated GIF as the file type. Give it a name, then you can choose a size, create a custom size, or start a multi-size layout. I'll just do a simple default one first. A couple things to note here is that I see a video track because I'm really in the video authoring environment to handle frame rates. The preview resolution is 1/2 by default, so if stage playback is important, you could change it. The timeline mode is advanced, quick mode's not available. Components and events are not supported, but dynamic and responsive are. And lastly, there's no add environment option. But you'll need to be aware of the different guidelines for each platform. I'll assume Google Ads for now, since it's the most restrictive, and with the 150 KB limit at this size, you'll probably need to keep your animation pretty simple. One trick is to limit the number of colors, so I'll just use 1 plus white. The file construction proceeds like any other HTML5 document, with shapes, text, and images. I won't be using any video. For my text, I'll pick some Google fonts, and there's almost 1,500 to choose from. I use the text controls to fine-tune letter spacing and line height. And in a simple design like this, I'll leverage the typography for my creative work. I'm centering all my text and using the alignment controls to center each element. Note, Align to Container is selected in the top toolbar. For the CTA, I'll pick a different font, but still in the same family. Now I can add some animation, and an easy way is to use text effects on this headline. I'll use Line Up, apply it, and change the sequence to word by word. Then playback to see the results. It's kind of slow, so I'll adjust the timing visually by editing this span, or I could enter exact values in the text effects panel. That looks better. Then I'll set a keyframe out here to hold on this text before repeating. If I nudge it back and forth, it'll preserve the empty keyframe when reopening the file, even though there's no change. Now I publish, locally, and here's some options for frame rate, which is 5 by default, resolution, time range, compression, and looping. But I'll leave everything at full quality. Then I'll preview. That looks okay. The animation's a little choppy, but I'm stuck with a frame rate of 5 for Google Ads, so there's not much I can do about it. I can check the file size by finding the exported file in my project folder. It's 96 KB and easily below the 150 limit. If I need to go smaller, back in GWD's Publish dialog, I can pull the colors down to 16, which is usually enough for two main colors like this. And dither helps when using more colors, so I won't really reduce it now. And now my file still looks the same, but it's dropped another 30% down to 65 KB. And if I need to reduce further, then I'd start using a third-party GIF compressor. Just Google search for free online ones, and that original file is reduced to only 12 KB. Now the 150 limit doesn't look too bad anymore. These are the tricks to making animated GIFs for Google Ads and AdMob. Other platforms like Display and Video 360 and Campaign Manager 360 are much less restrictive. And another way to create animated GIFs is from video files. I can start a new one. And here's one already built. This has audio and video content, but I can still publish a silent animated GIF from. Here's where I choose animated GIF, and here's where I choose the frame rate. But I've only got two options. So cancel this and back to my file. Deselect everything, and the Properties panel has all these choices. Let's try 12, and repeat. Now I have my 12 FPS option, and I'll leave everything else set to full quality. And here's the animated GIF version of this video ad. The size is about 7 megabytes, but I'm allowed 10, so it's still fine. And one last way to approach this is with an existing HTML5 banner ad. Here's an H5 creative based on a standard template, and if I want to turn it into an animated GIF, I'll first have to convert the doc type to video. There's some scaling and size options here I'll just leave as is to get the same size. And now I can publish as an animated GIF. And here's the results. Now I'll cover some advanced topics with the responsive and dynamic panels. But with animated GIFs, we use the term multi-size layouts and variants, because the final output will still be a set of fixed, unchanging images. For example, in this video file we converted from the banner ad, I'll make it multi-size, add a custom size, 728x90, and with that size selected in the responsive panel, all the changes I make now will apply only to this size. Everything I'm doing is standard responsive design from the HTML5 workflow with the base document, size, and range rule overrides. See the videos linked in the description for more info on authoring responsive documents. The purpose of responsive and dynamic authoring in this case is the convenience of keeping all your work in one file, instead of 20 different independent files. So for example, if I had to update my logo in the future, then I just do it once, and all those other sizes update automatically. The same for dynamic variants, where it's pretty common to try a few different headlines to see which one performs best. And here's my leaderboard design, and the original size is unchanged. Next, I'll create a dynamic variant. So first select Edit Base Document, and now I can set some dynamic bindings. Again, using the Outliner panel makes it easier to select these nested elements. On the headline, right-click to add a variant binding to the text content, and on my image, bind to the source. Now in the Variants tab of the dynamic panel, click this icon to make a new variant, and the pencil icon to edit it. I'll drag my new image into the library to load it. Then for the image variant, I'll select that file, and key in a new headline. And now I see my new variant, and again the original is unchanged. Now I'll publish everything. Here's where I choose the responsive sizes to export, and here's where I choose which dynamic variants to export. And the rest is the same. Note there's a preview range I can set in my timeline if I want it shorter than the full length. And OK. This publishes all combinations. And when I preview, I can choose how to view them, select the sizes, and the variants. And I find all these separate animated GIFs in my project folder, each named with the variant and size. That's it for animated GIFs in Google Web Designer. Thanks for watching.